Hello and welcome back to Markets at Noon. Sandeep Garg, MD and CEO of Welspun Enterprise, is now joining us. Sir, thank you so much for taking out time for us. In a time where we are only hearing news regarding people not being able to complete their project on time, you have actually gone ahead and completed a project much ahead of time, because of which you also got a bonus. Can you tell us what Welspun is doing differently for better execution?
So as I have been saying, that we are focused on operational excellence, and getting the bonus of our Delhi Merit Package 1 of 27 crores excluding GST is a milestone in our journey for operational excellence. So we are a focused company where we use the best contractors to deliver the project in the environment that we are. Another milestone that we also achieved, possibly which did not capture mind, was that we also completed a project called Devas Water Project ahead of schedule. So this is going to be a kind of our way of doing business, that we will continue to speed up the projects, try and do early completion of the projects, rather than playing a situation of delay and claims. We would be focused more on early completion and bonuses. So this is a way of our doing business, and we are very happy to have achieved that milestone on Delhi Merit as well as on Devas Water Project.
Mr. Garg, NHAI is, you know, definitely one of the most critical, one of the most significant clients that you are doing business with. Can you give us some color on how the scenario is playing out, and how the order book is looking in terms of inflow from NHAI, and would you be able to achieve 58 to 6500 crores or rupees of top line in the next 2 years on back of that?
So we believe that NHAI is doing a very good job. They are focused on the building the infrastructure, road infrastructure for the country. The continuity of the government and the continuity of the minister is definitely going to impact it positively, that the policy will continue, the HAM will continue, and I expect that the 50% of the 70,000 crores order which are likely to come out this year will be on HAM. So we believe that the ingredients are there, the focus is there, and it is only a ramp up that you will see from here on. And given the situation that we are in as a company, we are a very healthy balance sheet, very healthy profit making company with cash surplus available on our balance sheet. So I think with the kind of situation that we see in the overall market, both in the industry and the finance, it will be a very good time for the company to go forward.
Right. You know, when we just talk about execution, now that the mandate has come in, you know, people would be waiting for elections before new orders come in, or, you know, corporates would be, you know, worried whether they would want to take orders or not. But now that the mandate is clear, interest rates being where they are, and probably the expectation is that they would go lower, you expect infra activity to pick up?
I surely expect the infra activity to pick up. That is definitely my bet. We also expect not only the infrastructure activity to pick up in terms of road, but I also expect it to be picking up in the water. With the focused Jal Shakti Ministry being formed, I expect the focus to be there both on the river interlinking projects, the desalination projects, as well as the sewage treatment plants. So I expect the whole Ganga cleaning, this whole infrastructure play where we are focused, I see a huge growth potential. And I think the situation on the financial side of the business being where it is, and the interest rates being where they are, I expect the strong companies and companies with the balance sheet like ours will continue to grow, and would continue to have a situation where they can actually help country build the infrastructure that it desperately needs to build up.
Could you give us some color on your business model, because that has been evolving for the last couple of years, and if you could throw some color on the hybrid annuity model as well, and shed a little light on the company's approach for bidding and completing projects now, and what will be the model followed going forward?
So we are a very focused HAM project player or a HAM developer as far as the road projects are concerned. So the HAM model has practically remained static in terms of what it was finalized in 2015-16. So it's a model where the risk and rewards are balanced between the government and the concessionaire. We expect this model to remain where it is, but we would definitely be of the view that in view of the situation that the return for the concessionaire is linked to the bank rate and a spread thereon. However, with the bank rates going down and the banks not being able to pass on the benefit or the interest to the concessionaires, I expect going forward the government will look into this aspect. Government will be very keen to get the private participation. So I expect some modifications to HAM going forward. In terms of our approach is very simple. We'll target differentiated projects. We do not go for run-of-the-mill projects because that does, with our model of subcontracting, we cannot carry a situation where we compete for very low-value creative accretive projects. And we will remain asset-light. We do not invest into anything which is not necessary to develop the project. And we would continue to explore the possibilities of exit as soon as the projects are complete, both in terms of by way of securitization or by way of outright sale. So we will continue with our focus as far as the road is concerned on this model. In respect of water, we because this is a new vertical for us, we would look at EPC opportunities as well as the HAM opportunities. And as the vertical matures, we would reconsider as to what area we want to necessarily play in, or we would play in both the areas. So that's where our strategic calls are.
Sir, thank you so much for taking our time for us. Always good to get perspective from you. You know, let's also just focus on another NCLT case.